Today, I want to talk to you about the subclavius. Now, the subclavius is quite a small muscle and it's found in the upper part of your anterior chest wall, just here. Well, it might be small, but it can cause trouble. Want to know more? Of course you do. Keep watching and please hit that subscribe button. So the subclavius is quite elusive and we're going to have to hunt to find it. So let's start by identifying the platysmus muscle. Now this is a broad sheet of muscle found just underneath the skin and you can show yours off to great effect by clenching your jaw and turning your head to the side. Go on, why don't you give it a go? Clench your jaw and turn your head and there it is, right there. Not an attractive look, but at least you know where platysmus is. Now, if we peel that muscle off and look below the clavicle, you'll find that very large and powerful chest wall muscle, the pectoralis major, which we also need to remove. Now, take a careful look and tucked up just underneath the clavicle, can you see it? There it is. That's the subclavius. As you can see, it attaches to the first rib and the undersurface of the clavicle. So what does it do? Well, the subclavius is responsible for depressing the clavicle. Now, I don't mean emotionally. The clavicle doesn't sit there going, oh, just don't know what's wrong with me. Just feel so sad. That would be silly. What I mean is that the subclavius anchors the clavicle downwards and keeps it stable on your first rib, so as you move your arm and shoulder, the clavicle is nice and fixed. So I bet you're wondering why I'm making such a big deal about this muscle. Well, just have a think about what we do in modern life. Many of us, myself included, spend hours sitting bent at a desk with our shoulders hunched over, working on computers, or some people spend hours playing on computer games. So in this position, your subclavius can easily get tight and restricted, and this can have a knock-on effect, causing shoulder pain. So if you or someone you know has shoulder pain that is not getting better with regular shoulder exercises, have a think about the subclavius and give it a quick massage, as that may well be the cause to the problem. It could work wonders. For such a small muscle, you might be rather surprised to learn that the subclavius has its very own nerve supply, originating straight from our friend the brachial plexus, from C5 and C6. Can you guess what the nerve is called? Go on, have a guess. Well, the nerve that supplies subclavius is called the nerve to subclavius. Seriously? I guess whoever was in charge of naming nerves had a lack of inspiration day, or maybe they just thought that, meh, such a tiny muscle, who cares? Now that you know where your subclavius is, remember that anatomy is alive, so go and explore. Feel your clavicle, move your shoulder, and see how that clavicle stays nice and stable to your ribcage. So that is the Funky Professor's take on the subclavius. If you liked our videos, please give us a thumbs up, and more importantly, let me know what you'd like me to talk about next. And please hit that all-important subscribe button. Your anatomy,